Hello students, in continuity of chapter number 18, body fluids and circulation. Now, we are going to discuss about coagulation of blood. Simply, we can say blood clotting process, about lymph and main circulatory pathways. Now, you have clear idea about blood as a fluid connective tissue in human body. All of you know about properties of blood, composition of blood and role of blood in our body. Let's discuss about the process of coagulation of blood or blood clotting. We all have experienced that when any cut or injured part of the body, suppose if we cut our finger, at that time our wound does not continue bleeding for a long time. Usually the bleeding, the flowing blood stops after some time. Why it is so? Why does not continuously flowing or bleeding process is continue? Because in our body mechanism of coagulation of blood or blood clotting is there, and that's why after some time due to this mechanism flowing blood stops or bleeding process stops. Blood exhibit coagulation or that clotting in response to injury or any trauma condition. This mechanism is for prevention of excessive loss of blood from our body. We all have observed a dark reddish brown serum, that is the form at the site of cut or an injury over a period of time. So, clot or coagulation form mainly of a network of threads, and this network of threads is due to actually fibrin, in which bed and damage form elements which we have already studied. These elements of blood, they are trapped. So, these elements of blood, they are trapped within this fibrin. Fibrins are formed by the conversion of inactive fibrinogen in the plasma by the enzyme known as thrombin. Thrombin in turn are formed from another inactive substance present in the plasma called prothrombin. One more enzyme complex, that is thrombokinase, is required for the reaction which we have discussed here. This type of conversion, this enzyme thrombokinase is essential. This complex is formed by a series of linked enzyme reaction, or we can say also one type of cascade process. It's a series of this type of linked enzyme reactions. This type of process involving a number of factors present in the plasma in inactive state, and then it is converted into active state. Any injury or a trauma stimulate the platelets in the blood to release certain factors which activate the mechanism of coagulation or clotting of blood. Certain factors released by the tissues at the site of injury also can initiate coagulation. So, simply we can say some inactive form of substances as well as enzymes, series of enzymes, they play important role during the mechanism of coagulation of blood or blood clotting. Over and above these factors, calcium ions also play a very important role in clotting of blood or mechanism of coagulation of blood. So, now we can understand what is actually the process of blood clotting, why does it take place in our body, and which factors are involved during this mechanism. So, that's why for this reason when any cut in our body, suppose at that time wound does not continue bleed for a long time, but usually the blood stops clotting after some time. In this chart, we can study the entire series of mechanism of coagulation of blood or clotting of blood. One side you can see the direction which suggests injured tissue and changes after any injury or cut. Left hand side you can see the factors, substances or enzymes or ions which are responsible for this process, that is clotting of blood. So when at the site of any injured tissue, any cut, at that time you can see the release of thromboplastin, calcium ions, they play important role. Prothrombin is, that is present here, prothrombin conversion is there. Fibrinogen converted into fibrin, so fibers of fibrin and blood cell, ultimately the process of blood clotting. Okay, so this way the clotting of blood take place in our body. So we can say this entire mechanism is chain of reaction where these substances or enzyme release in our body, and at the end of this mechanism this entire process take place. Now let's discuss about lymph. As you know, as a fluid tissue, fluid connective tissue like blood, lymph is also one kind of tissue fluid present in our body. So to study about lymph is also important for us like study of blood. As we know, our blood is passes through the capillaries in tissue, some water along with many small water soluble substances move out of the space between the cell of tissue, leaving the larger proteins and most of the form element in the blood vessels. So when blood, it flow throughout the blood capillaries, the blood capillary wall is thin, diameter is very narrow, at that time this type of mechanism take place. This fluid released out is called the interstitial fluid or tissue fluid. It has the same mineral distribution as the blood plasma. We know about the composition of our blood plasma. So, similar type of material is present there. Exchange of nutrients, gases and some other substance between the blood and the cells always occur through this fluid. So this way it plays important role in our body. An elaborate network of vessels is called lymphatic system, collects this fluid and drains it back to the major veins. That is important here. This network of vessels, which is called lymphatic system, it collects this fluid and drains it back to the major veins of body. The fluid present in the lymphatic system is called lymph. So now we can understand exactly what is lymph. Fluid present in the lymphatic system is known as lymph. Now what is property of this lymph? Lymph is a colorless fluid containing specialized lymphocytes which are responsible for the immune system of the body. That is important here. Lymphocytes, this type of cells are present in composition of lymph which are responsible for the immune system of body. So we can say this way, they play important role in our immune system. Lymph is also important carrier for nutrients, hormones and some other substance. So over and above immune system response, also important as a carrier for nutrients, hormones and some other substances in our body. Fats are absorbed through lymph in the lacteals present in the intestinal villi. So for the absorption purpose of this fat are absorbed through lymph in the lacteals present in the interstitial villi. So like blood, lymph is also one type of tissue fluid. Okay, so during our circulatory system, when we study the blood circulatory system, it is important to study about the role of lymph also. What is lymph? Now you know very well. Okay, lymphatic system, well developed lymphatic system is present in our body. So it is made up of this type of lymph vessels, lymph nodes, lymph glands, and this way. So main function, it play important role in immune system. It provides immunity. As a carrier also, it play important role to carry some nutrients, hormones and other substance, as well as absorption of fat. So this way, as a tissue fluid, lymph also play important role in our body, like blood circulatory system. So we can say, as a higher organism in human body, well developed lymphatic system is also present. When we talk about circulation, means circulation of body fluids like blood and lymph in our body, so it's about circulatory pathways. Pathways of circulatory pathways, that is pattern, they are actually of two type of patterns: open and closed circulatory system or circulatory pathways. We have already discussed about this also during the study of animal classification, two type of open and closed circulatory system. What is difference between open and closed circulatory system? Open circulatory system is present in arthropods and mollusca, in which blood pumped by the heart passes through large vessels into open spaces of body cavity. These are called sinuses. So during this type of circulation, which is present in arthropods and mollusca, in which blood pumped by the heart passes through large vessels into open spaces. This is open spaces in body cavity, which are known as sinuses. Annelida and chordates, it means that we can say higher animals, they show closed circulatory system. Now what is difference between open and closed circulatory system? Closed circulatory system, here the blood pumped by the heart is always circulated through a closed network of blood vessel, which is present in open circulatory pathway. So now we can compare in between open and closed circulatory system this way. This pattern is considered to be more advantageous, as the flow of fluid can be more, you see, precisely regulated. So in lower organisms where open circulatory pathway is observed, in higher organism circulatory pathway is of closed type of circulatory system. In this chart also we can study these two type of pathways of circulation of body fluids, circulatory pathways of circulatory fluid, open and closed type of circulatory system. In chart also you can see open circulatory system is observed in arthropods and mollusca, and closed circulatory system, it is observed in annelida and chordates and all higher organisms. All vertebrate, they possess a muscular chamber heart. We know very well about heart and its structure. Fishes, they have two chamber heart with an atrium and ventricle, one atrium and one ventricle, so two chamber heart. If you move towards amphibia and the reptiles, here exception is crocodile, they have three chamber heart with two atria and one or single ventricle. So amphibia, reptiles except crocodile, they are having three chamber heart with two atria and one ventricle. In crocodile, birds, mammals, they possess a four chamber heart with two atria and two ventricle. So this way four chamber heart is observed here. In fishes, the heart pumps out deoxygenated blood, which is oxygenated by the gills and supplied to the body parts from where deoxygenated blood is returned to the heart. So, it's a single circulation of blood, we can say. In amphibia and reptile, the left atrium receives oxygenated blood from the gills, lungs, skin, and the right atrium gets the deoxygenated blood from other body parts. They get this mixed up blood, single ventricle, which pumps out is a mixed blood, incomplete double circulation, we can say. It's a mixing of blood, that's why incomplete double circulation type of pathway is observed. In birds and mammals, okay, oxygenated and deoxygenated blood received by the left and right atrium respectively passes on to the ventricle of the same side. Ventricles pump it out without any mixing up. You can say two separate circulatory pathways are present in this type of organism. So, these animals, they have double circulation. So, as being human being, our body, we show double circulation pathway because no mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood is there. It is separate pathway for both. So, you can say in different organism, primitive to higher organism, different circulatory pathways are observed, different circulatory patterns are there. It may be open or closed type of circulation. As well as when we talk about this type of circulation, at that time we can say in some organism, that is, it's a single circulation. In some other organism, incomplete double circulation is also observed, and in fishes and mammals, higher organism, actually like human, here we show the double circulatory pathway. So, circulatory pathway, we can study this way, the two types, open and close, and when we study in detail, it may be single circulation in some organism, in some organism it is incomplete double circulation, and in some other higher organism it is double circulation.
Now let's study this section of your heart to understand human circulatory system. Let's try to understand. As you know, in our body, human body, heart is four chamber, and circulation is closed circulatory system and double circulation pathway is observed. In this figure, you can clearly understand this both double circulation type of pathway in human body. Heart is four chamber, you can see here two auricles and two ventricles. Left hand side and right hand side, you can see the two chamber, it is two auricles and two ventricles. Nodular system is present in our heart, you can see here, that is atrioventricular nerve, is right ventricle, left ventricle get separated, right atrium, left atrium, they are separated here, vena cava, inferior and superior vena cava, that collect the oxygenated blood and it is emptied into right auricle of heart, right chamber of heart. Then it is passes through auricle to ventricle, okay, and this right ventricle to lungs for oxygenation process. And oxygenated blood is come back to this left atrium, left atrium to left ventricle, passes through the system, and then it is provided to organs of body. So through aorta, main artery, which arises from heart. So now we can understand this type of pathway, that is closed circulatory pathway, observe in human body. You can study human heart easily by this figure. You can study, you can understand four chamber heart structure here. that is closed circulatory system, and the double circulation pathway in human body. So we can say, sir, human circulatory system is well developed circulatory system.